Alrighty, so my name is Mr. Nice Guy.
I am Father Tom.
I'm me.
And we're here to talk to you about the recipe generator, What's Cooking. So to start us off, how many times have you been looking for a generator, or you know, you come home and you're really hungry, you got some leftover food here and there, but you really don't know what to put together. You know, you don't know many recipes. You know, your parents have always cooked for you, or you're in a rush, so you don't really know what's a quick recipe real quick. Well, that's one of the problems that we're trying to solve, because with a lot of the recipe generators out there right now, you know, you log on and it becomes a long process no matter what. So one of the main problems here that we're trying to address is kind of just the disorganization between these. So if you go on current super cook right now, so what we did was we typed in a couple breakfast things, so milk, egg, and bacon, and ended up turning into egg yolk. A couple different ones showed up, but you know, there's matches up here. It's if you continue to scroll down, it's kind of mismatched and everything like that. And then I clicked on one, and you know, you got some of the descriptions over here, lots of ads up here, ads down here, and you get a little bit of instructions, but it's not really detailed or anything like that. So it's not really customer friendly, and that's one of the problems that we're really trying to address, because customers want convenience, they want choice, they want control over products that they're having. So that's something that we're definitely trying to address. So like I said before, many of the app generators and the recipe generators make you sign in, and it makes it difficult to understand. The first thing when I clicked on this, it made me, hey, sign in from Facebook, sign in from Google, make your own. And it's really just a long process. So just to get the quick recipe, that's really what we're trying to accomplish here. And then also involves typing in foods. It doesn't always recognize them. There is choices on the side. So up here you can see choose from different categories. But again, it's just a huge mix of things, so it just really isn't organized at all. So some of the opportunities that I mentioned as earlier is a lot of the customers out there that are looking for something like this. They want control, they want the choice, they want the convenience. So again, with how many times have you looked up a recipe generator, and it brings you on to just this next page of, hey, you have to sign up, hey, you have to fill out all this stuff. So it gets annoying, it turns off, a lot of customers, you just exit out and say, no, I'll try something else, or, fine, I'll just do a little takeout instead of actually making anything, you throw away your food. So, and then, you give up on cooking, you throw your food away, and you never actually learn anything from it. You just spend some money and go for the cheap, quick resolution instead of actually learning something. So, moving on as well. Father Time here is going to take over.
I'm going to address partnering with Snooks, the grocery store, and the app that they provide. Me and my colleagues, we felt that it was smart for us to partner with Snooks because they already provide the grocery items that we're going to try to have on our grocery app, the recipe generator, I'm sorry. And the grocery store, Snooks, they're going to be our LCC. The customers there will be able to use the What's Cooking recipe generator to connect the grocery items that the Snooks already, that the store already provide. And the Snooks will also provide a pickup delivery option for our customers that stay at home or want to go through that option as well. And then, like we mentioned before, like the other competitors, they didn't have a customer-friendly type of user face. So with our user face, it's more customer friendly. It's very easy to use. We have our barcode scanning, and that's pretty self-explanatory. You just click the barcode scanning, and then you just hold up your phone to whatever the product is, and you just scan it, and then that generates, and then it goes into the items that Snooks has. And then with the fruit recipes and the veggie recipes, they're gonna come with the calorie count as well. So once you click on those, it's gonna have like a wide variety of the list of fruits and everything that's on there. So it's pretty self-explanatory. We also have the vegan, vegetarian, and allergy-friendly recipes. And you can also save the recipes to the cookbook. you can access those whenever you feel like it. And most of the recipes are pulled up from the past. So.
Okay, so some of the industry trends that we found is that most grocery stores, and stores in general, are going to mobile pay and pickup. It's one of the most current trends that most shoppers are using, and it's projected to make $314 billion in 2020. So a couple other things that are trending is saving time, saving money, and going green. So saving time, obviously, you don't want to waste a whole lot of time trying to figure out what to make. Saving money, I feel like that's, everybody wants to do that if they can. And going green, what we mean by that is not wasting, using your resources wisely. So what's so different between us and Supercook and Big Oven is the fact that we have barcode scanner. We have, you can save, where you can save your recipes, and we have bundle deals partnering with Schnucks. We also have a vegetarian and vegan friendly, allergy friendly, calorie count, pickup and delivery. So our value proposition, for families who are always on the go, who have a hard time coming up with meal ideas using what they have in their home, What's Cooking creates meals based off of ingredients that the user enters in the app. Unlike Supercook and others out there on the market, What's Cooking allows you to scan the foods barcode based off of your local grocery store, Schnucks, UPC codes, as well as order these ingredients for pickup or delivery from the customer's chosen store location.
All right, so kind of just to wrap everything up, you know, we told you kind of what's trending, what's the problems now with most of the recipe generators out there, that it's not really user-friendly or anything like that. Trending is the fact that, you know, companies out there like Schnucks, you know, they kind of want to get their word out there as well with app generators and recipe generators, because obviously that allows more food to be bought from them, increasing sales. And then it also kind of just makes people's lives easier with convenience, and it gives them the choice of what to do, kind of gives them control of what to add and to trash. So let's say you have like a certain recipe and you have an ingredient that you want to get rid of, such as like Father Time was saying, you know, with the cookbook and everything, you can easily just, you know, disregard a certain recipe or disregard a certain ingredient, and you know, that gives us the control and everything. So thank you very much.
All right.